Hi, I'm Stu, and welcome back to another LumaFusion video tutorial. Today we're going to look at some drone footage. I've got this clip from Jasper National Park, which looks pretty good. Now what I want to do is I want to add a little bit more cloud, and there's numerous ways you can do this, but one of the easy ways of doing it in LumaFusion is to go to Story Blocks and download yourself some atmospheric fog, which we can use as a cloud. The first thing we're going to need to do that is obviously blend it in and key it into what's going on underneath in this drone footage. So let's do that. So we will go to color and effects, go to the chroma key section, and instead of using green screen, we want to use dark luma key for this one. Tap on that and you'll instantly see things get dramatically improved. Now we're just going to scrub through and see what's going on. And I'm just going to play about with the settings so that the cloud blends in as well as possible. So the edge blur radius I'm really going to increase, and then I'm going to look at the erosion distance. These are probably going to get cranked right up. Play with the luma range and just get a balance. And you want it to be sort of floaty, ethereal, and disappearing. Now, color wise, it doesn't look great at the moment. We still need to make adjustments to what the cloud that you're placing in actually is doing, but we've got a bit of movement there, and stage one, we can see through what's going on underneath to a certain extent. So that's the first stage. Now the next stage is we kind of need to match the speed of the clouds with the speed of the drone shot. So if we look at it just now, the clouds are moving rather slowly. So again, if we go into our speed in reverse, and what we want to do is increase things. Now I've already had a play with this, and I know that probably around about 2.25 times speed is going to work out reasonably well for me. You can see the effect that's going on. So we're just increasing. You probably get away with going up to 2.5 times as well. Would work okay. Because obviously elements that are closer to the camera are going to move a lot faster than elements that are further away, which are going to appear to be slower. So we'll go for 2.5. And then from there, you'll see that my clip has now been dramatically reduced. Now we'll trim it at the end. Now the next thing we need to do is look at the scaling and the size and position and start thinking about dropping in some keyframes. So again, we just go into our frame and fit, and I'm just going to eyeball this and get some kind of position on it. So I'm going to start up here. So I've increased the scale and changed the X and Y position. Now we'll go to the very beginning of the clip and we'll drop a keyframe. And then what we want to do is go right to the very end and then think about moving the clip down, but also increasing the size of the clip. So that's my kind of finishing point. If we go back and play it through now, see how the cloud's now floating past? We're starting to get it there. And the actual swirling is in pace and time with the drone footage below. So it's enough to trick the eye. Then after that, the next thing we're going to do is go down to blending. Again, make sure at the beginning of the clip. Now I'm going to lower this to around about 94-95%. Just take the edge off it and have a little bit of opacity. That's the starting point. Tap on keyframe and then go to the very end. And even though the clouds all but disappeared now, I'm going to drop this down to around about 75% thereabouts. It doesn't have to be bang on accurate. And then again, when we play this through, it just means that as it's passing, it's also losing density as it would if you were actually flying through the cloud. Now the last thing we need to do to make this sort of saleable and make it work is the colour's all wrong. As you can see, the foreground cloud has now got this sort of bluey tinge to it, and the background is obviously very warm and yellow. So we need to go into our colour and effects, drop an original, and then from there, what we're going to do is go down to our colours and then increase the yellow quite considerably, but also add in a bit of red, just to give it that sort of slightly peachy orange colour. This might take a bit of tweaking, going back and forward and things like that. And then I'm going to look to increase the gamma somewhat, but also drop down the highlight amount, take the edge off it ever so slightly. So this is very much one of these sort of tutorials whereby you can play around a lot with it. And then obviously you'll be cutting into this footage at this point, and you're then just floating by. It's not perfect by any means, but it does work. You know, if I showed you this clip at the beginning of the video, which I'll probably do, it passes muster. You get, you know, a realistic sense of the foreground cloud disappearing and you actually flying over it. I'll maybe just tweak the color a little bit more. So we'll go in. Just trying to match the brightness to a certain extent as well. I don't know if we need more vibrancy. That could be the key. Yeah, I'll go for a bit more vibrancy. Again, just boost those yellows and boost those reds a bit more. Magenta's not going to help us here. I don't think green's going to do anything either. But it's starting to work. Again, just play through. Maybe a little bit too yellow now. Maybe that's the issue. We'll just go back into it. Just takes a bit of fine tuning. You can obviously grade this out with LumaFusion if you want, but maybe need more red than yellow actually. Yeah, that's kind of working again. Yeah, we get away with that. So what I'm going to do is, I'm just going to go to the back end of the clip and trim it. And I'm actually also going to go to the front end of the clip and start it around about here and trim it there as well. We'll remove the front end and then play. Is it just under 7 seconds or just over 7 seconds? And you can see the overall effect there. So that's just a quick and easy, cheap way of adding a little bit of foreground cloud into a drone shot, which can work well when you're just needing that little something in the lower part of the video, especially if you're maybe dropping in a lower third of that. And it's just a question of getting the right kind of smoky atmosphere. There's tons online. I mean, I went to Storyblocks for this, but if you Google fog or mist effects on black or 3D renders, that kind of thing, there are loads that you can basically use and tweak to your own needs. I think that looks pretty good. It's not 100% accurate, but it's passable. Anyway, hope you enjoyed this video tutorial, and remember to like and subscribe. If I've earned your subscription, that's awesome, and I will catch you on the next one. Bye!